Hi, everybody. My name's Chris Gethard, and I'm the host of The Chris Gethard Show. And our guest on tonight's episode of The Chris Gethard Show is Jon Hamm. Hello, Jon.
Hello.
Thank you for being a part of my show and a part of this video. Very nice of you.
It's my first video.
Yeah. They're really intense.
We'll see.
It's very nice of you to do my show. One of the things I'm most proud of with my show is I think we book really good bands. We book a lot of underground bands, and music is something that's very important to me. And the kind folks at Rolling Stone were hoping we could have a conversation about just the role of music in our lives in general.
Okay.
Yeah. Are you a music guy?
Do you No.
Not at all?
No.
Wow.
Well, all right. It's because I felt like, and this has been backed up by other people's opinions, that I have the worst taste in music in
really?
The world. Which I don't think is necessarily true, of course, because I like it. I happen to find it fine. I think it's just too mainstream. I think I like whatever happens to be on.
Are there any particular examples that people have said to you, let's...
I think for some, at a certain point I was trying to explain to people why ZZ Top was great.
Yeah.
And I got no takers.
I mean, they're in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Somebody gets it.
I mean, there are, to be fair, many people in the Rock and Roll
Hall
of Fame.
That said, I think most girls are crazy for a sharp-dressed man, A.
Yeah.
A lot of people have legs.
Yeah. And those beards are back. Now those
Clearly.
Beards are hip. Now those beards
Clearly.
Are hip.
They were prescient. They were way ahead of their time.
Yeah.
Three dudes from Nowheresville, Texas, 40 years ahead of a beard trend.
Yeah. So I want to know what else you were, because ZZ Top's the first thing
sure.
that came to mind. So I have some guesses. I feel like when I was a kid, it was almost illegal to not like Guns N' Roses. Were you a Guns N' Roses guy?
I'm a little older than you. So,
yeah.
I did get into Guns N' Roses, but I was a little, old for them.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, okay.
Like, I missed the whole kind of, like,
that was
if
like
there was
80,
any
80,
hair,
80,
metal, hair metal bands that I was down with, I was, like, half a generation
yeah.
earlier. So it would have been, like, Def Leppard. Also, like, in my sort of later years, again, coming from the Midwest, I went to school in the Midwest, and, like, alt country kind of started right when I was coming through.
Yes.
So like Uncle Tupelo, which begat Wilco and Sunvolt and all that, the Bottle Rockets, all that stuff was kind of brewing around. That was sort of my
yeah.
fun thing. But also it was the super, super, super heyday of like hip hop. So it was like
yeah.
there was so much good, like Yo MTV Raps was like a must see TV for my generation.
Were you into it? Were you into the hip hop?
Sure.
Does anything stand out?
I remember I got to see Public Enemy live when I was in college in Columbia, Missouri.
That's right.
Which was, yeah, but you're also kind of like, we're still in the middle of Missouri. Like, this is, we're
yeah.
in Boone County, Missouri. There is not a lot of, like, social upheaval.
Yeah.
911, it isn't a joke here. It's
a service.
It's, it's a service.
It's a service people use sometimes.
And sometimes, you know, you have to call it if your cat's stuck in a thing.
Yeah. I would love to see Public Enemy. That would be like a, I would imagine the.
Although, and most rap shows that I've seen, not great live. A little bit like
I've
watching
had the same experience.
Watching a board game live. It's just
yeah.
not fun.
I've had the same experience.
Super fun for the rappers. They're having a blast.
Yeah.
Everyone else, it's kind of the mix is off. You can't hear anyone.
Super
always
fun
the
for
one
the
one guy who's too close to the mic and who's drowning everybody out.
Yeah.
Flavor Flav.
I think rap shows are specifically most fun for the rappers' entourages. Like the other guys
the,
on stage.
The hype man?
The hype man?
Having a blast.
Being a hype man seems like the most fun job
what a great
in
job.
The world.
You literally just have to dance and enjoy yourself and not do anything specific.
Yeah.
Other than enjoy yourself.
And I'm sure like hang out after the show and be cool.
And probably, yeah, get all the ladies.
Yeah.
Men, look, gender non-specific.
No.
Let's not be that guy.
2016.
2016. This yeah. is all about, it's the year of yes.
Mm-hmm. Big time.
My first concert, care to guess? You'll never guess it in a million years. And I could maybe even give you his single that was the hit.
A hit?
Then maybe you would guess it. Every time you go, you take a piece of me.
Mm-mm.
So, all right, remember how that was?
It must not be because it's the thing pop. You're saying it would be hard to guess. Is it, oh, because my initial gut instinct is wrong. I thought Rod Stewart.
No.
It's not that. It's Brian Adams?
Very close. Paul Young, who
Paul
is sort of like
Young.
A B-minus Brian Adams.
B-minus
That was my
Brian
first...
Adams.
Sorry, Paul. We all kind of know it, right? I'm not telling you anything you haven't heard before.
My first concert was in a church basement in New Jersey.
And it's sort of like Fugazi or somebody super cool. Or...
Way lower level, but punk bands. One Nature, The Missing Children, and Felix Frump.
Yep.
Local bands, local Jersey bands. Yeah, I mean,
Zero.
I'm bringing up Felix from New Jersey, everybody except for...
Well, let's bring him out. Felix?
Yeah.
No soup for you. I have wonderful memories of working really with everybody involved. I mean, it can go on and on. Julia, I guess the best would be...